lights on a bright home. I can get there with my eyes closed. Exactly 34 minutes after I pour.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all doing really well. So today's video is something that I have been meaning to film and wanting to film for so long. And I keep talking about it on all my social media. It's like, alright, I'm finally gonna do a makeup room tour, finally gonna do it, but I just keep putting it off because if you guys have followed me for some time, you would have known that about 18 months ago, almost 2 years ago now that I think about it, I reckon, we sold our home, and within that time we were renting and we built the brand new home that we're in now, and we really kind of just customized this new home to suit our lifestyle, our wants and needs. It's kind of like our forever home for now, and we decided to put a studio into the house for myself so I could work from home with clients. I have got a substantial amount of makeup, so we did decide to put a beautiful storage desk in the room, and I would have loved to have shown you guys what my makeup room looked like at the rental, but I'm a little bit of a perfectionist. I feel like I love to present things in a certain way, and I just really wanted to wait till this incredible room was put together to show you guys and really just kind of showcase everything. I'm just like beside myself with how happy this room is. It's so like me, and I take a lot of pride in it because this is really who I am. So welcome to my makeup room tour. Yes, I have a room completely dedicated to makeup, but it is part of my job. I am a content creator, so I'm very fortunate to receive a lot of gifted product. But also I am a freelance makeup artist, and I have to have a lot of product stored away for clients and stuff like that. So I just wanted to show you guys pretty much how the room looks, how I've styled it. I know you guys are always quite intrigued on my stories whenever I give you a little bit of snippet of everything. I thought I'd just do a quick little disclaimer for you guys. Not that I really want to, but I feel like I kind of have to. Just please bear in mind that while I'm taking you through a tour through my makeup room, it is not in any way trying to show off. Just please bear in mind that this is my job and I do receive a lot of makeup. I need a lot of makeup to do what I do as a freelance makeup artist, so this is not about showing off. I know that there are so many makeup enthusiasts out there who like to look at products and see what's out there, look at other people's collections, and basically just be a little bit nosy. I know I love to be nosy as well, and I'm more than happy to share that with you guys. I would definitely say I've got a little bit of an issue when it comes to collecting makeup. It's probably just a very passionate hobby of mine. I love makeup, as you guys could have already guessed, but it's just something that I don't know, I kind of like think it's like my prized possession. Like, I'm very proud of all my makeup and I love collecting it and keeping it like nicely displayed, and I don't know, I just, yeah, this is like, oh, my everything. So anyways, let's get cracking into the tour.
Okay, got some little visitors here before we even start the tour. Okay, so first impressions when I open up the door into the room. This is generally what my clients get to see when they first arrive for their makeup booking. So as you can see, I've got my makeup desk there with a whole heap of storage. Now, we had this custom made when we ordered the kitchen for the house. Kitchen Designs put this together for us. This is actually a kitchen set, but they kind of custom made it so that it would work for myself for storage. They custom made the bench as well, and that's a beautiful kind of glossy marble finish. And then I've got these beautiful photo frames from Pepe HQ. These are just incredible. They're the biggest statement of the room, and that's what I wanted when I ordered these. Now these are A1 frames, and this came more as a set. I love the color tones, I love the elegance of them, and I wanted a really nice big beautiful feature for the room when you walk into it. The flowers in the corner, they are just from Mikasa here in New Plymouth, and then they sit on some of my very favorite makeup books. Now, if you guys have followed me for some time, my first ever makeup book that I ever bought was by Ray Morris. When I was teaching myself makeup, I was reading her first ever book, which is The Express Makeup, and I learned a lot from her book. And then, surprisingly enough, after years of working as a makeup artist and going off a lot of her basic makeup tips, I actually was contacted by Ray herself to send me her new book. Honestly, could have cried, so that is very sentimental to me. Okay, I think we'll start with this top drawer here. So this is all my mascaras, eyebrow products. You've got eyeliners and liquid liners. They all sit in these little dividers. Well, they're actually just little plastic containers. I picked these up from the plastic box here in New Plymouth. I'm pretty sure they're only like $2 each. We've got heaps of products from Benefit here when it comes to brows. Some of my favorite stuff like Ready Set Brow. We've got the Browsing. We've got some stuff from Anastasia Beverly Hills. Brow Pal by The Balm. And then we've got just like a whole lot of pencils underneath, but yeah, as you can see, it's kind of like packed to the brim. So if I get anything new, generally something has to get sacrificed out of here. Looks like I'm hoarding here, but honestly, all these products at some point in time will get used. If it's not for myself, it's definitely for clients. So we've got some of my favorite mascaras in here. Grandiose by Lancome is one of my absolute favorites. I love that one. And then we've got the Shock by YSL. Again, another favorite, but my absolute favorite is the Lash Power by Clinique. That's waterproof, but removes with warm water. It's such an amazing product. Just got an array of different mascaras in there. Everything from MAC to L'Oreal to Maybelline, just a huge range. In here, we have got a whole lot of liquid liners. So for example, we've got a heap of NYX liquid liners, which I use a lot when I do creative makeup. So I have a huge stock of different colors in there. And then in here, we've got all Kohl pencils. So you've got things from like Urban Decay, got a couple of different colors in there. Again, by Terry, we've got, I've got quite a few of those actually. How did I end up with so many of these? Everything from The Balm, Maybelline. And moving on to eyeshadow, so this sits beside my mascaras and brow products. This is one chock-a-block of a drawer. Eyeshadow palettes take up a heap of space and I've only allocated one drawer from it. We've got products like the Urban Decay Troublemaker palette, Jouer Skinny Dip, which is a beautiful shimmery eyeshadow palette. Probably one of my most favorite eyeshadow palettes, which I'm too scared to even use, is by Tom Ford. Over here I have quite a range of Zoeva palettes. So we've got the Basic Moments, we've got Screen Cream, Sweet Glamour, just a really cool range of different eyeshadow palettes, like the matte one. I've gone through the Cocoa Blend, which is one of my favorites, so that is just sitting in my drawer at the moment for my personal use. Then we've got things like the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette. I sometimes pull this out for certain shades, but some of the other ones I just find super chalky. Urban Decay, MAC, MAC and MAC's new eyeshadow palette. Got things like Solar Flare by VH Cosmetics. I've got a really nice collection of high-end and drugstore, which I like to have for you guys when I do tutorials. I don't like to have just like pure high-end products. Then I've got a range of The Balm products like Meet Mattes. Probably my favorite one from that collection is the Meet Matrimony, which you guys can see I've used a little bit of. I used to use it all the time in tutorials. Got a couple of Shannon's palettes in here, which are always really good to work with. You've got lips. And then on the other side, you've got eyes. Then we've got Urban Decay like Moon Dust, which I've done a tutorial on. Some really cool shimmers in there. This one was recently bought out by Lancome. This was limited edition with some pastel-y kind of colors in there. Also have eyeshadows like the Too Faced Life's a Festival. So you've got some holographic shades in there. Can be a bit of a hit and miss with Too Faced with these kind of palettes. Depends. I just find you've got to be really careful. Like, some of them are really nice. This one's a little bit chalky, but I just hold on to it just in case I want to use it for something and I can work with it with certain other products. So this eyeshadow palette was the first ever PR eyeshadow palette sent to me. This is by Sourcebox. This is the Forbidden Fruits palette. And as you can see, I definitely used this one so much. I actually really loved the pigmentation in it as well. It was incredible. Okay, let's move on. Okay, so in these two drawers are my lipsticks, lip glosses, matte liquid lipsticks, lip liners, lip balms, all in between. I could honestly sink a boat. In here we've got all the liquid lipsticks, we've got glosses. This is kind of like my cute little high-end kind of corner with YSL. And then we've got all MAC. Also got some EXO Beauty in there, and then we've got a heap of MAC ones. I'm actually gonna swatch a couple of these because this one arrived just the other day and it's such a cool color. It's got like a metallic iridescent kind of flick in it. I just love the full pigment that you get from matte liquid lipsticks from MAC. So yeah, they all sit in there as well. In here are all my glosses. So we've got things like Unicorn Tears by Too Faced. This is like an iridescent gloss. Oh gosh, what have we got here? This is another limited edition from the Nico Panda collaboration with MAC. Just like the cutest freaking packaging ever. We've got some stuff here from more MAC glosses. Got some Urban Decay here. A Geochromatic by NYX. So this is new. They've just got like a holographic duo kind of finish to them as well. So this little container here are just all my kind of like high-end, pretty to collect lipsticks. I really love just the packaging of them. So we've got a little bit of YSL here, and then we've got Clinique underneath. Quite a lot of just YSL really, a bit of Tom Ford. This is actually super new. This is number 19 from YSL. Just a really beautiful limited edition. I just love how luxurious looking it is. So these kind of just sit here. They're kind of like my little pride and joy in the corner. I would definitely say probably the tinted balms are my most absolute favorite packaging of all lipsticks. It's just so like elegant and classic and chic. In here we've got just a whole collection of MAC. We've got a heap of limited edition here, which you guys can see. For example, this is from the Aaliyah collection, which recently came out, just a beautiful red. We have the Selena, Patrick Starr, Mariah Carey. In here are just all my lip liners. So this lip liner definitely has a place in my storage. This is by Jordana. This is the Sugar Plum lip liner. Again, this was one of the products that I used with that makeup look with the Saucebox Forbidden Fruits palette. This was my first ever lip liner that I ever bought, and I used it multiple times in so many tutorials. It's definitely like my first ever kind of purchase, my love when I bought it. So that always sits there, and I haven't used it in some time, but I'm sure I will soon. Okay, and in the other drawer again, kind of just like, I've got a shit ton of matte liquid lipsticks, it's ridiculous, but in this one we've got things like, we've got a heap of Zoeva, we've got some Stay Matte by Rimmel, a heap of Gerard Cosmetics and Lime Crime, a little bit of Huda Beauty, we've also got some Stila, Caitlyn, Ofra, Mela Cosmetics, The Balm. These are like all the little minis, so these are a heap of mini lipsticks in here, really cute Bobbi Brown ones, like again, very similar to YSL, just very chic. We've got some NARS, some mini liquid lipsticks by NARS, these are super cute. These are just great for traveling in. I say this now, but I never actually take like mini size stuff with me when I travel, I just take like my normal kind of stuff. So we've got that, then we've got some NYX minis. I just hold on to these for like more creative makeup again, because you can see there's some wild colours in that, so I hold on to those. So in this little container, these are just mainly like balms or treatment products. Okay, I have to show you guys these. So Lipsmakers bought these out and they are so friggin' cool. I love them. They smell and taste just like the actual product. So you've got like Coke, Fanta, Sprite, and I just love these when they came out. They were so much fun. This container here, honestly, just a random stock of stuff. I've just got a wide range of the collaboration of Balmain with L'Oreal, EXO Beauty liquid lipsticks and glosses. We've got some Urban Decay, Sephora, just some random stuff in there. And that's basically it with that drawer, I think. I forgot about this. This is a recent launch from YSL. This is the Lip Collector lip palette, which is so beautiful. I'm not gonna use this yet, but this will be going into my kit. I've already got a Bobbi Brown palette like this, so once that starts to get quite low, I'll replace it with this. But how beautiful is that packaging? It's just so stunning. My third drawer, these are basically all my base products. You've got things like powders, highlighters, blushes. So in this drawer, we have just got a wide selection of stuff. In here, for some reason, I've just decided to put all like my gold products, like all the gold packaging in here. So we've got products such as YSL again. I love their packaging. This is a brand new blush, and they've just bought out a new highlighter as well. And then this is an old limited edition blush that they had, just a beautiful peachy tone. So they sit in here, and then a couple of hourglass palettes of their blushes and illuminators. So back here we have, so these are all the face palettes that complement the Zoeva eyeshadow palettes I showed you guys earlier on, like the Screen Queen. So you've got some blushes and highlighters in there. Sweet Glamour with some more brighter colours, more pastel-y. Basic Moments, which is a really nice basic kind of palette. This one is the Offline, which is quite vibrant. We've got the Opulence, beautiful tones, a little bit more dramatic, and then the Artiso. In this little container here, we've got a heap of just cream products. So everything from like contouring to highlighting to blush. This is from Tom Ford. I love anything from Tom Ford because it's such a beautiful brand. Blush stick, I really like the blush on this. I know that looks really intense, but when you buff it out, it just comes into a really nice kind of peachy tone. Highlighting sticks from Hourglass, Mika by Terry Blush, some more Hourglass. Got a bit of Rimmel, got Milani Baked Blush. I think I've got like 3 Soft and Gentle by MAC. A little bit more MAC. This is a limited edition product from Lancome that was kind of like a, I'm pretty sure this is like a, it's a cushion foundation, so it actually isn't even meant to be in there. Some more blushes by MAC. I have quite a bit of MAC face products. We've got a Chanel, this is super duper old. A collection of Jeffree Star highlighters here. Probably the only one that I generally go to is the Peach, I think it's Peach Goddess. Yeah, Peach Goddess, which you guys can see I've used a little bit of. I love how big the packaging is. Obviously the pans are a lot more like thinner, so they are easier to break. So I've got quite a few of these strobe creams by Zoeva. To be honest, I wish I reached for these a little bit more, but I don't. I just naturally do not use creams over powders as much, but I've got quite a nice collection of these. I will one day find a purpose for these. Okay, onto the other side, we've definitely got another random mix of stuff. We've got heaps of face powders. We've got so many highlighters, so many highlighting palettes. Heaps of pigments, glitters, so this is quite a hectic drawer as well. Like, as you can see, like, literally nothing else can go in here. Again, one of my most favorite packaging alongside YSL is Tom Ford. This is a very beautiful face palette. So we have a heap of face palettes here. These are the Strobe Spectrum palettes by Zoeva. We've got the winter one, which has got some really cool toned colors. This is actually a brow product by Zoeva. I actually do not use this palette much anymore. I actually found there's a lot of fallout that comes from them, and I hate that, so I don't know what to do with that palette actually. We've got the Spring Strobe palette by Zoeva, Summer Strobe, and this is their contouring palette, which is a powder. We have some Huda Beauty, Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit. I actually really, really like this one. I always thought it was overrated until I started using it. I was like, god damn, this is amazing. Now in here, we've just got a huge selection of pigments, glitter eyeliners, all that sort of stuff. I don't even know where to start with these. So I've got a really nice little collection of Furla's pigments. This one is called Shady. These are so beautiful. They're really, really pigmented. I'm gonna do a swatch of this for you guys. These guys are cruelty-free and vegan, and they do such beautiful pigments. This is super duper silky, and this is not wet. This is completely dry. So you can imagine if that had a little bit of moisture to it. So these ones here are really cool. These are new from MAC. These are quite similar to the Stila liquid eyeshadows that are out. Great thing about these, what I've found, is that they do not dry and crumble, unlike the Stila ones. Okay, in here we also have things like Inglot, which I really, really love working with. Got a heap of DB brand glitters. I love playing with these when I do more creative looks. Okay, I think we're gonna leave that drawer because there's so much going on. Moving on to the bottom drawer, this is full of primers, concealers, and setting sprays.